You come right back underneath it. There you go. Last Tulane interview until the Hall of Fame.
Oh, I think Parker. Anyone know where Parker is? Yeah, I was going to make sure he was here.
Michael, how did they go overall?
I thought it was awesome. It's great to be back with all these guys, get to spin it around, have some fun. It was great.
Now, when teams have so many years and seasons of film from you, for you, how much weight does a pro day hold?
I think it's just another opportunity to come out here and throw the ball and, you know, showcase what I can do throwing the ball, but then also how I interact with the guys, you know, just the camaraderie that we have, you know, shows our relationships together. And just, you know, it's just another opportunity to come out here and play football and have fun.
When you hear that you could potentially be the first Tulane quarterback drafted since J.P. Lozman in 2004, how does that make you feel?
It's awesome. It's awesome to put on for the city, put on for the school. You know, I'm super proud of all the accomplishments that my teammates and I have made, and just super thankful and blessed to be in this position.
And what does that say about the program?
It says a lot. You know, what Coach Fritz implemented here while he was here, for, you know, the good chunk of time he was, just the culture, the city, just embracing it. The people of New Orleans really came together and got behind us, and, you know, were a great asset to us and helped us out. So just putting on for the city and, you know, continuing to build this program, I think they're in great hands with Coach Summerall. I'm really excited to see what they're going to, you know, continue to do in the future.
So you were talking, a lot of people think about this as a physical workout. Obviously you got to throw the ball well, but you were also talking about some of the intangibles, interacting with teammates. That, you feel like that was important today to show that?
Yeah, I think it's always important. You know, the guys, obviously, that have your tape, they see you throw, but then there's the intangibles, like you said, you know, how you interact with the guys, you know, the relationships that you have, and, you know, just to be able to come out here and even just throw into the DBs, just that relationship that I have with all those guys, being able to show that, and just having fun is another thing to showcase.
Do you think the intangibles are a strength of yours, something that you can bring to a locker room?
Yeah, absolutely. I think it's really important. It's something that, you know, is judged at the next level is your character and how you can be an asset to the locker room and how you can, you know, elevate the guys around you. You know, as a quarterback, you got to lead. You got to lead by example. You got to be a vocal leader. You know, ultimately, if the guys around you aren't, you know, producing the most that they can, you're not going to be as successful, and vice versa. So it's all about the camaraderie, building those relationships, being together, and making everybody else around you better.
You seem like a guy that isn't, your whole life hasn't been deterred by challenges, all the way back to high school, right?
Yeah.
You went and took on a bigger school, right, to try and show. I mean, you feel like this is another aspect of that going to this next level?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, I think that's just a part of life in general is, you know, overcoming and conquering, you know, the next difficult task. You know, things are going to be thrown at you. There's going to be adversity in everything that you do. And I feel like ultimately, you know, there's winning and there's learning. So in all those adversities and, you know, all the tough times, there's always things that you can take out and that are beneficial and how you can implement that in your life going forward.
What did you feel like you needed to show teams once the season ended?
Once the season ended, really just being a quarterback, I think the interviews are really important. You know, obviously, like I said, there's all the on-the-field stuff. There's throwing the ball. But, you know, they watch the tape. They see your footwork. They see you know, your mechanics, your ball speed, you know, your touch, deep balls, you know, intermediate game, all that kind of stuff. But, you know, it's what you can do under pressure, going to a place like the Combine, the Senior Bowl, playing at a higher level. You know, so just having those opportunities to compete at the highest level around the best guys in the country is just some, you know, it's just another opportunity.
What would you like to hear on draft day? Like, draft, where would you like to?
Where do I want to go?
Yeah.
whatever team wants me. You know, I'm super blessed and fortunate to be in this situation and kind of just give it to God, and, you know, wherever he wants me to go, that's where I'm going to go. Just take it away.
I know that Fat Watts is back on the team. He looks pretty good for you.
Yeah, he's looked awesome. You know, he's been through some struggles, you know, injury, adversity, but he's back. He came out, helped me out. So super thankful for him coming out here and running some routes for me.
Can't have a better D-ball than that one.
Yeah, no, that was awesome. Yep.
What do you want?
Thought that this might, I mean, do you think you'll be working with these guys again, or will this be maybe the last time you're throwing with some of your guys you've been with the last 3 or 4 years?
I'm going to hang around here until probably the day after the spring game. You know, that way I can, you know, go see the guys practice, all the younger guys that I played with last year, and, you know, get to spend some time with them. So I'm sure all these guys, Keys and Quan and all the guys that are around, will continue to work out and throw, obviously, because we're, you know, continuing to try to get better. So definitely going to have a couple more workouts with those guys. So I'm excited for that.
What do you want NFL teams to know about Michael Pratt?
You know, I think the biggest things, like I've said a couple times, is, you know, there's all the on-the-field stuff. You know, they have their assessments, they see how I can throw the ball and, you know, process, and they have the film, but, you know, how I can be an asset to the locker room, how I can be a leader, you know, is the things that I think is really important, elevating the guys around you, you know, is something that I take a lot of pride in. You know, we went through a lot of adversity my sophomore year in that 2-10 season, and the way that, you know, we just kind of came together, you know, in the locker room, we made it a lot more player-led. You know, the guys kind of, you know, took it to heart after that tough season that really could have been a 10-win season instead of 10 losses. And, you know, just the way that we all came together, I learned a lot from guys like Tajay Spears and Nick Anderson, Dorian Williams, Sincere Hainsworth, you know, just the leaders, the main leaders of the team, of, you know, how to create those relationships, how to push the guys around you, how to hold people accountable, how to be accountable, you know, discipline, all those things that are really important in this game.
You mentioned Tajay and Dorian, obviously they went through this process last year.
Yep.
Have you gotten to kind of talk to them about this process as a whole and what to expect?
Yeah, I mean, they went through it. You know, I've talked to them a bunch. I talk to Dorian all the time, Tajay every now and then. You know, just embracing it. You know, it's difficult. You know, for me, I like to, you know, kind of have a routine. I like to stay on schedule, you know, plan ahead. And, you know, throughout this process, there's a lot of different things that are thrown at you. And, you know, it's just taking it on, you know, head first and, you know, trying to thrive in everything that you do.
Mentally, how do you kind of compartmentalize as the days and weeks go by and mock drafts happen and all these predictions and projections and people analyzing your game? How do you kind of compartmentalize all that going into the draft?
I mean, for me, I tune it out. You know, ultimately, none of the media and all that stuff is really going to, you know, there's so many different mock drafts like you're talking about and saying I'm going to go here and go there and this round and that round. Really doesn't matter until it comes down to draft day. So just putting that to the side and not paying it much attention, and just controlling what I can control to continue to get better and prepare for, you know, once I get my opportunity.